She's inspiring to young people because she's such a timeless figure that she can reach into the hearts and minds of every generation. And I think we really see this with the Queen's Young Leaders Award.
We all look for role models, we all look for leaders. I'm privileged and proud that we have the number one leader.
There's no one quite like the Queen on today's world stage. After 6 decades, there's hardly a statesman she hasn't met.
She's seen tyrannies come and go, dictatorships, Soviet Union, end of apartheid. She's seen all that incredible history. And she has a real grasp of, you know, the world picture.
The Queen's experience of global affairs is especially useful on one particular evening in the year. The diplomatic reception is one of the biggest events in the calendar. 600 envoys from more than 130 countries descend on Buckingham Palace. Everyone wears their finest uniforms and fanciest national dress. The reception is organised by the Marshal of the Diplomatic Corps.
When people are talking about it, they refer to it as the diplomatic reception, or the evening reception. We refer to it in the palace, but there's no doubt what we are talking about. It is the most important event in the year. It makes a tremendous spectacle. Everybody dresses up either in their national dress or in the white tie and tails with decoration. This is one of the few nights of the year when it takes me longer to get ready than it takes my wife.
Tonight, the Queen and her family will shake hands with the world.
First you think you're in some sort of fancy dress, because it's just unbelievable, the colours and different varieties of dress and everyone, it's incredible, it's very surreal, and there's a lot of people, a lot of hands to shake, and a lot of different cultures and languages.
She remains so calm and collected all the time as well.